Welcome to Azura's Norwegian Fjords Cruise 2016.
I glimpse all the places you've been to, the things that you've shown us, the stories you tell. I glimpse, so I sing to your spirit, the men who have served you so long and so well. I glimpse all the places you've been to, the things that you've shown us, the stories you tell.
And then you have to go. Break the chocolate. Lisa, because I have not. They're usually.
You have to be ready.
991 us. Yeah. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you the master of Azura. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a huge warm welcome to Captain Derek. There's a lot of new people on board Azura this cruise, and what you need to understand is we do everything a lot bigger and a lot better. So ladies and gentlemen, please join us and give it a very warm welcome to the master of Azura. Let's hear it for Captain Derek Gray.
Yeah. Oh, what a resounding welcome. Well, thank you very much. Completely unrehearsed and not coaxed out of here at all. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that really can go one of two ways, can't it? That would be quite interesting to walk out as you're all going, boom. But thank you for the cheer. Well, ladies and gents, I take this opportunity to welcome you all on board Azura for the 7-night cruise up around the fjords. So we've all got ourselves settled in?
Yes.
We've all found somewhere to sleep?
Yes.
We've all found somewhere to get something to eat?
Yes.
We've all found somewhere to get a drink?
Yeah.
All found the gym.
Alt på stell, fått kjæring I hus. Selfie dronning, linselus. Utrolig hva som finnes inne I Oslofjorden. Hun nikker og smiler, men skjønner ikke nå. Sjeleglad, har fått en plass å gå. Jeg håper hun liker lukta av ku og korn. Med leppestift og arbeidshanske på. Nå blir det mat og fuck, og hun går uten tråd. Segway og jord.
och jord.
Oh, he's missing himself.
Kind of nice, isn't it?
Molten, it is molten.
Thank you.
we're going to a scenic sail away with our senior officers on observation deck above the bridge.
Spill some down my shirt.
How do you like the burger? Well done, not bloody as hell.
I would happily marry this burger, have 5 burger children with it, then get life insurance on them all and eat them all. And then life insurance.
To buy more burgers.
Mm-hmm.
good burger. I'm going to eat yours.
Just another reason to move to Norway, to be honest.
Make light work of that.
This is the remnants. Okay.
But I don't think anybody's yeah. Very good, very good.
Okay, once again, good morning to you all. As the boss mentioned, my name is Nesta. I'm one of the restaurant managers on board. This is my 11th year with the company. I've started the Azura, and you can ask me a lot of things, as Dave and Juliet will tell you. Part of this furniture for this ship. And as we progress through the journey, I'm here to answer maximum questions. So now we head on to the bakery. Then we go to the sauce section, the soup section. We see the patisserie, and we see the dispense bar. And then we head towards the starboard side to see the other side of the operations. Are we excited?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, excited.
Yes.
That's better. You're my guys. You should be the most noisy ones. Let's go. Please come in. So now we are entering into the port side, into the main galley. Okay, this galley designed for the Meridian restaurant. Okay. As you can see, the distance bar over here. You see the head wine stewards are out. Your will. A lovely bar stewards over there.
All right.
You can see the pastry over here. So we are now going to our first destination. That is the bakery. Okay, so now we are right at almost towards the aft end of the ship. Beyond this point is the crew mess, which is in operation. We won't go over there. So this is our deck 5 main bakery. And that's our head baker, Mio De Costa. Been with the company for almost 20 years. 20 years with piano, he started with the age of 5.
Around 12,000 rolls we produce per day. Whatever amount you put, it flattens in seconds, okay? This takes around 45 minutes to bake the bread.
Soup section. This is the soup section of Azura. The soup for the entire ship's company, officers and our passengers. So we are looking out 4,500 guests. We are making soup over here. Okay, it's a 24-hour operation. The lads have just gone for the lunch break because the peninsula will be opening now for lunch, and also the buffet will be opening for lunch. So they must have their lunch before we start our operation. So, two people work in the night time and two people in the daytime, and they work on the shifts. So what we do is the big one, we can make 370 liters of soup over here in the big one, and in the smaller one we can make 165 liters of soup over there in the smaller one. And that's Mr. Leslie. And he's been with P&O again for 19 years. How many years? 19 years with P&O. Yes.
All right. 90?
19. 90 years. All right. So I'll leave you to chef.
Thank you very much. Hello everyone. Welcome to Azura Pastry. My name is Leslie. I'm a chef producer. I have 15 chefs working with me. It's a 24-hour operation from night to day. including the afternoon, and it will continue. The operation will continue for 24 hours. So I have four chefs working in the night who do the major production, the buffets and the restaurants. And I have four chefs in the day, they come late in the afternoon and end up cooking. You can see all the plates, presentations, like so the celebrity chefs, they come on board, they train me, I train my chef. With the same menu, we follow the same restaurant for the customers for the passengers for afternoon break. Yeah, fine.
Thank you. Thank you, chef. Yes. That's Chef Leslie.
How many people will come at what time? But the good part, this cruise, being a Norway cruise, everybody likes to see the fjords and all. They're all coming early, this cruise. So we are getting almost almost 35% of the crowd. We do everyday analysis. Because we have done this once upon a time. That's why we have reached over here. So now you are on deck 5 in the dishwasher area on the starboard side. Okay. This dishwasher is for the Meridian restaurant. And let me introduce you to Mr. Ben Fernandez, the galley manager, the in-charge for the galley operations, all on board the Azura.
Hello all, I'm Ben Fernandez, galley manager for Azura. I have a dedicated team of 65 and a dedicated supervisor team of 4. Together we are the moral support of the life or backbone for that community.
Title, senior chef de cuisine, reports alongside what's your executive chef. You must have seen him, the celebrity chefs, Watcher's right hand man, most important man on town. The whole and soul was selected by the company to send to the Buckley Square in the UK to study the menu about the Michelin star restaurant. Stands over here. And your waiters, in the evening when they take your orders, it's a triplicate. Okay, the white copy goes to the galley because it is precise, clear, so it's easy for him to count exactly. So you can see, he's taken the orders over here. Starter, one salmon, one asparagus soup, one sea bass. So let's say it has all been entered over here. So the first copy goes to the kitchen. The second copy goes to the assistant waiter, and the third copy is left at the with the waiter. So over here, this gentleman's job is to make sure every half an hour he counts how many forks, how many beef, how many chicken went, and towards the end of the service, he will physically feed all the data inside the computer. And responsible for 14,000 meals per day, our very own celebrity executive chef.
So. Hopefully, Prabhu explained to you about the cold area and the preparation, the night prep and everything like that. So during the lunch times and the dinner times, we use the hotline. So the hotline, we section it off. You know, the pork dish is going to get done there, the sea bass dish is going to get done here. And then behind that, we'll have, say, 4 or 5 guys who are putting each item onto the plate. So unlike other cruise lines, I know because I've worked on different cruise lines, we don't plate everything up in advance, everything is done to order. So we work as near to the finest line as possible. If we're cooking steaks for the dinner, we are talking with the guy upstairs, because we have another galley upstairs in deck 6, which is a mirror image of this. So we've got the guy there that looks really shocked that we're pointing at him. He's the diet chef. So when the waiters come in and they shout diet chef, he comes and he hands over the specific order, because we have now more than ever, you know, you've got nut allergies, lactose intolerant, gluten intolerant, allergy to oxygen and all this sort of thing. Him and his team deal with everything like that. So it's all completely separate. So this whole area down here, this is where they produce everything. So it never crosses over. So Rakesh now is preparing some of the hot starters. During the dinner, Rakesh works upstairs in Sydney. So he specialises in the fine dining, in the select dining restaurants. And he works upstairs in Sydney. And then we've got John. John's in charge of all the hot production for the main galley, so he produces all like the sauces and things like that upstairs, and any hot production he's the main guy to go to. So if anything's wrong, John's the man to...
Oh, there, welcome. Hello, welcome, welcome. Yes, welcome.
Seabass is very popular.
Seabass is, it's going to be a fishy afternoon. I can sense that. It's going to be a fishy afternoon.
Poor Mali.
So that's the whole operation.
Which is Mali?
Malik, Mr. Malik. Malik,
I'll have white for now, please.
Have you enjoyed yourself? Too much food? But still room for...
Well, I don't think there's room, but...
I thought you might have had that actually. Could have done with a potato with it.
You've got a smear of tatty. There's a bit of tatty underneath your spring roll as well, isn't it?
No, I think it's melon. That's that melon as well.
Yeah, this is not bad.
This is our pre-dessert. It's a lipstick of... It's tasty.
Raspberry, I'm all right. Can you guess what it is yet? Oh, I can't say that now.
And
which fourth
one? Antique raspberries and
thank you.
Thank you.
Doesn't want to. Yeah, it's sad, isn't it?